I know what I'm about to say is going to shock people too, but when I was a teenager, I lost my virginity in a rape.
Demi Lovato alleges she was raped when she was 16 years old.
So what, I'm supposed to come out to the public after saying I have a promise ring? 6 months later, I'm supposed to say, well, actually, I had sex, even though it was rape.
I think some of the conversations about prior trauma in her, the earlier years of her life, were really heavy. I wasn't sure when or if we were going to talk about those in the detail we did. And I remember that happening and feeling it was just a really intense moment.
Episode 3 of the I Love Me Singers 4-part docu-series, Dancing with the Devil, dropped Tuesday on YouTube. And while the 28-year-old entertainer doesn't name names, she does open up about losing her virginity when she was a teenager.
We were hooking up, but I said, hey, this is not going any farther. I'm a virgin and I don't want to lose it this way. And that didn't matter to them. They did it anyways. And I internalized it and I told myself it was my fault because I still went in the room with him. I still hooked up with him. Here was the thing, I was a part of that Disney crowd that publicly said they were waiting till marriage. And then I had to see this person all the time. And so I stopped eating and, you know, coped in other ways.
That's when Demi says she started self-harming and developed an eating disorder.
Bulimia got so bad that I started throwing up blood for the first time.
Were there any moments that come to mind where you had to stop filming, where she needed a minute, or moments that come to mind to you as the most powerful, intense interviews you did with her?
I never stopped filming. And you know, there's always this battle because you become very close with whoever you're working with, and you've got your friend hat on at that point, and then you also have your professional one. You're there to do a job, right? Everybody's there to ultimately get something done. So when something so genuine is taking place, you need to roll. As much as your instincts are, you have to fight those urges to sort of stop, because that's ultimately what the person wants, and that's, you're there to see that through.
Demi says that she did tell someone about the alleged rape, but nothing was ever done about it.
And you know what? F it. I'm just gonna say it. My Me Too story is me telling somebody that someone did this to me, and they never got in trouble for it. They never got taken out of the movie they were in. But I've just kept it quiet because I've always had something to say, and it's like, I don't know, I'm tired of opening my mouth, so. There's the tea.
And after that, she never spoke about it publicly for fear that people wouldn't believe her. But now she's hoping that telling her truth will help others.
I'm coming forward about what happened to me because everyone that happens to should absolutely speak their voice if they can and feel comfortable doing so.
As she reveals this trauma from when she was a teenager. And she mentions that this person was someone who was in movies, so my guess is that fans are going to go online and they're going to try to figure out who this is. Did you and Demi talk about revealing that person? Do you know if she has any intention to? And how did you decide where to leave that in the documentary?
If you remember that moment in the film, she sort of comes to the realization and says, you know, I'm also going to talk about this. My job in that case is to be the ultimate listener and to capture the moment and to provide her a safe space to tell as much of that story as she's comfortable telling. And we had talked about that, whether it was specific to this moment, which again, I wasn't aware it was coming, or other moments. So when that moment did present itself, I just had to document it and not push her further. You know, it wasn't for me to try to dig. And I think she shared what she was comfortable sharing, and it was brave to do that. And what she said is ultimately in the final cut.